What's the first famous death you remember being aware of?
JFK's assassination. I was in second grade, lovely late fall day outside. Someone came in and whispered something to the teacher. She covered her mouth with both hands and sat like that for a few moments. Then she said very quietly, "The president has been shot. The school is closing early. Everyone is going home now." I liked Kennedy, but I could not really grasp what it all meant at the time. I walked home with some other kids and watched TV for the next 3 days along with everyone else. I remember feeling very impressed by the funeral procession, especially the riderless horse. Freddie Perez. I loved watching Chico and the Men with my dad. He had to tell me that he died, and I think he even told me that he killed himself, because I think I remember not realizing until then that you could shoot yourself, like, never thought about it. Then, they aired the final episode with Freddie and I was so confused, thinking TV was live. My dad had more explaining to do that night. ETA, it's weird as hell that I don't remember Elvis. I think I must have not caught the news that day. My parents weren't into him, but I very much remember John Lennon's death. Robin Williams is the first one I specifically remember. It was about a month before I turned 8. I had to ask my parents what it meant for someone to hang themselves. But the first one that impacted me was Carrie Fisher, followed by her mother. I'm sure I heard about David Bowie, who is now my all-time favorite artist, but I only knew his name and that he made music when he died, and I remembered George Michael dying as it was a few days earlier, but I wasn't all that familiar with him either. I was a Star Wars fanatic though. Princess Leia dying hurt pretty bad. Princess Diana. That being said, I'm from Czech Republic, and at the time of Lady Di's death I was with my parents at the children emergency room for extremely high temperatures. The doctors weren't sure I haven't got meningitis at the time, and one of the nurses just came to the room and said Diana is dead. It took years for me to realize who they had been talking about, but yikes. At the time I was about 6 or 7, and I still remember the moment when the nurse said it, the kind of by the way remark, while it had been quite important at the time. Michael Jackson. I was in the car with my mom and was driving us somewhere I'm not sure, and she loves some of Michael Jackson's songs. Every radio station just out of nowhere started playing non-stop Michael Jackson, and she was enjoying it, but we were also confused as to why every station out of nowhere was playing nothing but Michael Jackson. Finally, after flipping between the stations non-stop, that's just how my mom uses a radio, we stayed on one station long enough to see what happened, where they announced that he had died. Elvis Presley in 1977. He was fat and stoned and wealthy, and he loved food and he could devour it at any time. He could have pleasure with any hot woman. I think, as for myself, that the drugs were getting to him, annoying him. He did not want to do live shows and he did not want to make an appearance at the gala party. He started out very extroverted and became very introverted because of weed and alcohol and pills. He held the record for most live shows in Las Vegas until this year. New York City singer Barry Manilow beat him. Born 1965, so I remember Pablo Picasso and went to art school, so this made an impression. Alexander Calder, Harry Truman and LBJ, all within a year or two of each other in the 70s. My parents weren't into rock and roll, so don't remember anything said about Janis Joplin, Jimi Hendrix or Jim Morrison in that same period, although I remember my mom talking about Judy Garland's death at some point. She was into the True Detective style magazines too, so some at game type details came up out of questions about the lurid covers. Princess Diana. I was 12, and just days before we heard the news I had seen an unflattering picture of her in one of those shitty paper tabloids at the checkout counter and left. I felt so fucking bad for that. And then seeing the funeral with her children in the cars and the wreaths on her casket mummy. My god. My family had been through brutal accidents and health scares my whole life, and I had a paralyzing horror of losing my mother. I felt so absolutely shattered with grief for her sons. John Lennon. We had radios on the school buses and an emergency news report came on making an announcement. I didn't understand that John Lennon was the lead singer of the Beatles until later that night when I saw the full news report about it. I was 9 and extremely sheltered, cut me some slack, but I remember the bus driver started crying fairly badly, which is always concerning when you're a kid. Then I also got a little upset later when I realized who John Lennon was. Princess Diana. For some reason, I couldn't sleep despite it being around 5:30 in the morning, so I got up, went downstairs and put the TV on to watch some cartoons or something. I was 9, but this news was on every single channel. A few minutes later my sister came down to see what was going on with all the noise I'd made, and we kinda just sat there together in a daze watching the BBC reporting on it before sprinting upstairs to tell Mom and Dad about it. Selena Quintanilla, though it might not count BC, she died the year I was born. But every year since I could remember, around 4 or 5, I remember her death anniversary was a big deal. My parents would have on her annual TV special and the Selena movie would play. I remember it made me so sad. The one I was alive for was Michael Jackson, and Jesus, it felt like the world stopped. My parents had the news on for hours and we even went out to get ice cream. John Lennon. My mother listened to the radio in the bathroom every morning while getting ready for work. I'd listen for a bit from my bed before getting up for school. I was 10, and I really liked that starting over song on the radio by some guy named John Lennon. I had no idea at the time just who he was. I'll never forget the DJ talking about his killing the night before, and then they played Starting Over. I was floored. Princess Diana, but for some reason I thought she was already dead by that point. A year later I heard about Shari Lewis, but I didn't want to admit that it didn't really matter to me. My mom thought I would be upset, so I acted sad, but she'd already made Lamb Chop. I was far more appropriately saddened by the death of Joey Jordison, mostly due to the circumstances surrounding it. Winston Churchill. I was 9 years old. Watching the state funeral on black and white television, I commented to my mom that I thought they'd done well to get it all organized in a week, or however long it was. I was absolutely shocked when she told me that the funerals of people like Churchill and members of the royal family were planned years in advance. JFK assassination. Was in 5th grade and our teacher must have gotten word because she went and turned the radio on she kept at the back of the class. Heard the announcement that he was pronounced dead. Believe we also heard of Oswald's capture. When I got home, I told my mom, but she hadn't heard yet and was shocked. Flipped on the TV and there it was. Fuzzy memory here, and I do think the three were close-ish in time, without googling. Roy Orbison, Princess Diana, and John Candy. I believe Roy precedes the others by a few years. Edit, now that I have googled it, Roy is the first in 88. Mog, half man, half dog, passed in 94. Then Diana, Princess of Wales, passed in 97. All good souls lost too soon. I kind of just remember 1997 as a whole when it came to celebrity deaths. There were so many that year: Biggie Smalls, Princess Diana, Chris Farley. It was a year I probably became aware of celebrity deaths in general, because I knew who they were. I was alive for others, but I was more aware of it than for some others of the earlier 90s. Jim Henson. I was only 3 years old, and while I was watching Sesame Street or a Muppet movie, my dad told me the Muppet guy is dead. I was devastated and for a long time also confused, because I couldn't figure out which guy Muppet was missing from the newer show's movie I watched. My dad had no filter but was a good dad. I remember when Raul Julia passed away, he was one of our famous octoses from Puerto Rico, and he was Gomez and Bison. He was pretty big. It was just so sad he passed. Fuck cancer. Also Selena. I remember people crying in public, it being all over the news. I think it was because she was so young and full of promise. Elvis Presley. My school bus driver screamed at us, "Shut up, the radio just said Elvis died." Me and my friends were all around 10 years old. We knew who Elvis was, but couldn't understand all the adults freaking out about it. All our parents told us to go outside, so we played waffle ball until the streetlights came on. When Elvis' death was announced on the radio, my mom pulled the car to the side of the road and wept for quite a while. I was a child and didn't really understand what was going on. Years later, when the guy on the radio broke in and told us that Stevie Ray Vaughan had been killed in a plane crash, I did the same thing. I had to Google to see which came first. Diana and then Jill Dando. I remember my brother rushing up the stairs in the morning to wake the whole family and tell them that Diana had died. I was 9, so don't think I really cared very much. Jill Dando was a few years later and I understood better what had gone on. Michael Jackson is the first one I can remember. I was 12 or 13 at the time, so I'm sure there were earlier ones that I was aware of at the time, but Michael Jackson's death was such a big deal that it's the only one that stuck in my memory. It's hard to describe how shocked people were when the news came out. When I was a middle schooler, I went on a family vacation up to the mountains. Michael Jackson died and my family was glued to the news. Then Billy Mays died and I was so sad because I liked his commercials. My parents made fun of me for being more sad at Billy Mays dying than Michael Jackson. Ayrton Senna. I think he was the only famous Brazilian who never had a hater. He was humble and polite, intelligent and talented. When he died I was like 6 years old, I guess, and I remember I was taking a bus with my mother to get home and people were all silent and looked sad. I think the first one that I realized the impact of was the Space Shuttle Challenger. I was old enough to understand those were real people and I had watched them wave and climb aboard excited and the next thing the explosion and remember the realization I just saw them die. Aaliyah, when I was 6 years old. Ironically, this was a month before 9/11 and yet I don't remember the events of that day. I do remember hearing about her death since her music was all over the radio at the time, plus it happened right after she finished a music video, Elvis. I was in the drive-thru for a new McDonald's, only our second fast food restaurant in a small town, so it was very exciting and it came over the radio that Elvis died. 8-year-old me asked my mom if she knew him then why she was crying if she didn't know him. JFK just got back home, mom had taken me to cinema and my grandparents had the TV on and it was JFK assassination. Friday tea time on the UK. I was 7. Also vividly remember Bluebird somersaulting on Coniston when Donald Campbell died in 1967. Filled me with horror. Alias Smith and Jones was a western with two bad guys going straight. Unfortunately in 1971 one of the stars, Pete Duell, shot himself. I swore that I was going to grow up and be a detective and prove it was he shot himself. Locked room non-mystery. Prince Edward's death in 1972, the Duke of Windsor and late Queen Liz's uncle. I remember it well because I couldn't get my head around the fact that he was the king but was called a prince when he died. I was only 7 and didn't understand what he had done. I was in my 5th grade class when our teacher announced that JFK had been shot and killed. One kid cheered. The teacher lifted him out of his seat by his collar and yelled at him. I'd never seen an adult treat a kid that way before. It was scary and absurd.